So I am hoping to be able to get this done in one pour, but I'm highly doubting it. But we shall see. We shall see. These are brand new jugs I had to order because this job is a lot bigger than what was anticipated. So what I am going to do is I'm going to measure this by the jugs and just put the jugs beside each other with how much. Now I'm hoping close to half, because what I've been noticing so far is how much I've been using when I did the red was a little off, that it didn't do that much. It wasn't as thick as I was hoping. I will now take this guy. I will use some felt on him so I don't contaminate the two. And then I will measure. So these guys become the same height since it is a 1-to-1 ratio. Now you have 15 to 20 minutes of play. I noticed with this new kind that they have, and as we can see, there's plenty there still. So a bit more. And that looks pretty darn close to me. Now we won't have any issues. If we see something that changes in the heights, we could add, which I already see a bit. I will give another little tiny gulp, because this one's a little bit thicker, so I know it takes a little bit longer for it to go down and set back where it's supposed to be. So we will leave those side by side so you can hopefully see with the camera, you can see that they are level. This is a clear coat that we're doing. I'll put this on number one speed because you're trying to get minimum bubbles inside this. Thank you. Wanted diamonds sparkles inside this, so we're going to use quite a bit of sparkle. I'll add this last. It's called glitter powder because of the LED lights that we have all the way around, and this will make it so it sparkles a lot. Give it a diamond effect so when the LEDs come on, etc., it makes it sparkle. Okay. And by the looks of it that we can tell so far, we're going to need a heck of a lot more. But I am loving the effect that it is giving so far. The bubbles. I'm going to let this go in. letting it run to all the corners to fill in. Then I will lay it flat so it'll come back this way. And then hopefully cover majority of the one side. So then when we self-level the other way, it will cover everything else and fill in all of the areas. But from the looks of this, this looks like he's going to need so much epoxy. I'm not sure if he even really wants to try to do that much. As you can see, this is a very long process, very tedious, and I don't recommend it to anybody. Not on large scales like this. Unless you have lots of money to burn. Okay. Just waiting a few more seconds. That'll go into that corner and that crevice. Almost there. And we have full coverage. There. Now I will lay this back normal and let it go as flat as possible. I will reheat this up a little bit to help. Give it some heat, that way it can move a lot easier without overcooking it. This also takes up any air bubbles. Mixing process, as well as making this more thinner from the heat, so it will level up better. So that was 1/3 roughly of a jug, and it literally only covered not even an eighth of the LEDs. And there's still about an eighth left of the plexiglass. So this looks like it is going to be literally a jug alone, which is $192 Canadian. You will not see this line when you pour the next level because it always covers up and it fills in the way it goes. The way you won't see ripples or anything like that. But very cool. I like it. It's pretty nice. Very clean looking. As you can see how nice the lines are now on the doors and stuff. You can see how clear it looks. So it has a nice reflection. So we'll play it by ear and see what happens.